Welcome back to IT Free Training's course for Active Directory. In this video, I will look at a new feature in Windows 7 and Windows Server 2008 R2 to automate the management of service accounts. This video will show you how managed service accounts can be used in your organization to simplify user account management, remove the need to manage passwords for service accounts, and give you a higher level of security. To refresh your memory about service accounts, a service account is simply a user account that gets created to run a particular piece of software or service. In order to have good security, you will want to limit a service account to one application or service. The problem with this approach is the management of these service accounts, and in particular, the management of their passwords becomes difficult. In one of our previous videos about computer accounts, we learned that a computer account is created for each computer in the domain. These computer accounts have a password associated with them that is automatically updated without any intervention from the user. Managed service accounts use this system for password updating. This means that if you use a managed service account, you never need to worry about settings or changing the password. The password used is a random string of 120 characters. This makes managed service accounts very secure, as the passwords are not easily guessable. By default, the password is changed automatically every 30 days without any intervention from the administrator, just like the passwords on computer accounts. Managed service accounts are bound only to the one computer. This ensures the service account will not be used other than on the computer it was created on. Managed service accounts can be placed into groups, so this is a workaround to give them access to other resources on the network if you need to. Before you start using managed service accounts, you need to meet a few requirements. First, the domain function level needs to be Windows Server 2008 R2. Managed service accounts also require schema changes. For this reason, you need to run adprep/forestprep using the Windows Server 2008 R2 DVD in your forest. This will expand the schema to meet the requirements for managed service accounts. Even though you need to expand the schema, you do not need to raise the forest function level in order to use managed service accounts. The next requirement is that the client that is using the managed service accounts is running Windows Server 2008 R2 or Windows 7. Lastly, you need some software components installed in order to create the managed service accounts and configure them to be used with that computer. These components are .NET Framework 3.5 and the Active Directory module for Windows PowerShell. Both of these can be installed by adding the component using Server Manager. Once you have met all these prerequisites, you can start using managed service accounts in your organization. The next step is to determine which software will work with managed service accounts. Managed service accounts don't work with all software. By design, they do not allow the interactive use, which means no support for GUI-based operations or logging in the computer via the login prompt. You'll need to check that the software that you are trying to run supports managed service accounts. Here is a list of common Microsoft products and their level of support for managed service accounts. Exchange supports managed service accounts, except for sending emails. This means that you can use a managed service account to run Exchange, but will need to configure another service account to handle sending emails from Exchange. Next, managed service accounts can be used in IIS to configure application pools. In the demonstration, I will look at how to configure a managed service account to work with IIS. Microsoft listed SQL as not being compatible with managed service accounts. A lot of people have used managed service accounts with SQL and had some success. The risk you run with using a managed service account with SQL is that if you have problems, Microsoft will not give you any support for that configuration. Next, a managed service account cannot be used with the task scheduler. Lastly, a managed service account can be used with Active Directory lightweight directory services. not to be confused with Active Directory Domain Services, which is a software used to run a domain controller. Active Directory Lightweight Directory Services is used with third-party applications that require some of the features of Active Directory, but do not need a full Active Directory environment. In order to get Active Directory Lightweight Services to operate with a managed service account, some additional configuration needs to be done, but Microsoft does support this configuration. I will now change to my Windows Server 2008 R2 member server to look at how to configure a managed service account to operate with IIS. First of all, I want to make sure that the prerequisites for managed service accounts are met. To do this, open Server Manager and select Features. From Features, select Add Features to see which features have already been installed. The prerequisite for the .NET Framework 3.5 or above framework is shown at the top as being installed. Scrolling down, I can see that some components of remote administration tools have been installed. These were installed to allow Active Directory administration to be performed on this server. The important thing to look for is that Active Directory module for Windows PowerShell is installed. This allows PowerShell to interface with Active Directory to create the service account and configure it to be used on this server. Now that I know that the prerequisites have been met, I will exit out of here and from the Start menu open PowerShell. The first command that I will run is import module Active Directory. This command loads the Active Directory module, which allows Active Directory administration to be performed from PowerShell. If you do not run this command, all the other commands will fail. The next command, new AD service account, will create a managed service account. The name of the service account needs to be given with the name parameter. In this case, I will create a service account called Managed IIS Service. This service account will be used later on with IIS. Following this is the enable parameter followed by $true. This ensures the managed service account is enabled when it is created. This server is not a domain controller, but since it has Active Directory tools installed, it is able to create the service account in Active Directory. If I now open Active Directory Users and Computers from the Start menu, I can see the newly created service account by expanding down to Managed Service Accounts. Any managed service account will appear in here. It should be remembered that even though it appears in Active Directory here, it is still tied to the one computer. If I minimize Active Directory Users and Computers and go back to PowerShell, I next need to associate the service account with the computer that it will be used with. This is done using the command add adcomputer service account. The first parameter, identify, is used to specify the computer that the service account will be linked to. In this case, this will be server 1. The next parameter, service account, specifies the service account that we want to link. In this example, it is managed IIS service. So basically, this command is linking the service account managed IIS service with the computer server 1. The previous commands could have been run on any computer that is able to perform Active Directory administration. The next command needs to be run on the Windows Server 2008 R2 install or Windows 7 install that you want to use the managed service account on. PowerShell can also connect to a computer remotely to run the command as long as the command's target is the local computer. The command is install AD service account. The only parameter that you need is identity, followed by the service account name. This command makes the necessary changes on the local computer in order to allow the managed service account to operate. Now that all the hard work is done creating the managed service account, I will now open Internet Information Services from the Start menu to change the service that is used in IIS to the service account that I just created. From IIS Manager, expand down to Application Pools. From here, right-click on the Default App Pool and select Advanced Settings. From the Advanced Settings, select the option Identity. Currently, this is configured to run with the default settings. This means a local service account on the server will be used. When running multiple pools in the same IIS install, you may want to create each pool to run with its own service account. There is nothing stopping you from using the same procedure that I went through to create multiple service accounts and associating these service accounts with the same computer. Once I select Custom Account, I can press the Set button to specify the managed service account. For the username, enter in the managed service account, but make sure the username ends with a dollar sign. Managed service accounts differ from regular user accounts in that a dollar sign must always be added to the end. If you do not enter in the dollar sign, Windows will not be able to find the managed service account. Having the dollar sign at the end can mean some Windows interfaces will not be able to detect the managed service account. A workaround is to place the managed service account in a group. The Windows interface should not have trouble finding the group and using it, even though it cannot find the managed service account. Since Active Directory will automatically change the password for the managed service account, leave the password blank in the Password and Confirm Password fields. That's it. I can now exit out of here and go back to the application pool, which will now be using the managed service account. To show that it worked, I will stop the service and start it again. The managed service account is now set up, and the administrator will never have to worry about changing the password on the account. Also, since the service account is bound to this computer, even though it is located in Active Directory, it cannot be used on any other computer in the domain. In the next video, I will look at the exam objective Offline Domain Join. This is another new feature available in Windows 7 and Windows Server 2008 R2. This allows a computer to join the domain when it does not have access to a domain controller. Thanks for watching another free video from IT Free Training.